Hi all, it's Andy from SolarReviews here again, and today I wanted to make a video for you around the issue of how to size a home energy storage or solar battery solution for your home. So by way of recap, you know, for those, most of you are probably aware, but for those that aren't, standard grid connect solar systems, and up till maybe 2 years ago, 90%, 95% of homes that put solar panels on, you know, simply had solar panels and an inverter with no battery backup. And what that means is that when the power goes down, the utility goes out, to protect utility workers that might be working on lines, those grid connect inverters, you know, under the NECA code, the electric code, you know, they have to switch off in those circumstances. A lot of people didn't realize that, you know, they could have a solar system but still have no power in a blackout. And so in more recent times, people have wanted to have batteries such that, and a different type of inverter that's capable of islanding the solar system from the grid in an outage, such that the solar system and the battery can continue to power your home during an outage. The question, given that these solutions are out there now, the question, you know, is what size solar battery do I need? Because one of the things people probably don't understand about solar batteries is that there really is not a lot of point having a solar battery that, you know, has a capacity where you don't ever have enough surplus power to charge it in some cases. However, in other cases it might be worth, and most of the, you know, the modern solutions now support, you know, charging the battery from the grid as well as from the solar. So the upside of all that is there's a few different options you have when solar sizing. So if we jump into an example, and again I'll use our online solar calculator, it's a solar calculator that's not behind any sort of registration or paywall. It's pretty much really high quality solar estimating software, but it's made available for free to consumers on our website without having to register. So I'll go through an example. In this case, I'm using Anthony as an example. Anthony's the man behind the camera at the moment. He's lives in New Jersey, and he's considering solar and possibly battery storage for his home. And so what we'll do is we'll run through the economics. So Anthony's bill was a bit bigger than this, but I went for a $200 a month bill in New Jersey because it was perhaps a little bit more normal than Anthony's. His was around 350. So what the estimator shows is in this case that Anthony would need 38 panels. I think that's based on a 370 watt panel, so it's probably about 34 or something, 400 watts or 410 watt panels. Basically he needs a 14 kilowatt solar system. If he just buys a grid connect solar system, you know, his savings over the life of that system will be about 94,000. So, you know, he might have gross savings of, you know, more like 120, 130, but then obviously take the cost of the system off and you get your net savings here. It shows the 30% solar tax credit available, and also, you know, a program in New Jersey that gives a discount for SREX. What we come to down here though, the purpose of this video really is to focus on this thing. So what we have is we have a few different options for how he could size a solar system to go with his house. The first, probably the most economic one, is just to size it to store surplus solar power. You know, solar generates most of its energy towards the middle of the day, sort of say between, you know, 9 and 3, or you know, 10 and 2 even, probably, you know, the best generation times. So and typically residential homes don't use a lot of power at that time, and so, you know, solar generates surplus energy. The reason people haven't needed batteries in the past is because of net metering. They got paid the retail amount for solar power that went back into the grid, excess solar power during the middle of the day that wasn't needed by the home, that went back into the grid. But a lot of people now want battery storage for two reasons. One is they want to know that they've still got power when the utility goes down in the case of a storm or wildfire or something like that, or even just general maintenance, you know, failures, trees falling on power lines, things like that. You know, so that's one reason. But another reason people are more and more looking at battery storage now is that regulators are foreshadowing that one-for-one net metering, you know, is unlikely to be around for a whole lot longer. So there's a number of different reasons people want batteries and a number of different ways you can size them. So what our calculator does is provide a number of different ways, and the most economic here is simply getting a battery that will store what surplus solar you have available. So in this case, this home would need, you know, a 32 kilowatt battery bank. So they'd be made perhaps looking at something like 3 Tesla Powerwalls. It does give you an idea based on, if we click here and you see the weekday, you know, in winter weekday, it knows, you know, the gap here between the grey line and the blue line, you know, is periods where there's excess solar power, and so effectively all the area above the grey line in here, that's all available to go to a battery. So, and it works it out at, I think, 15 minute increments, so it's pretty accurate. So you can use this to go in and size your battery. You can also choose to say, a different way of looking at battery storage is, well, look, on an average day, I want to run, be able to run all night off my battery. So effectively, I want to size my system up. So whilst I have the grid there as a backup, unless it's a particularly overcast or poor weather week, I can basically run, in an average week, I can run off battery and solar. So if that's what you want to do, again, you can adjust that and recalculate. You can basically put in different loads, and this will estimate the loads based on what's typical for those appliance, lights, refrigerators, central ACs, and work out how much battery capacity you need. So in this case, you know, if you want to be able to run a central air conditioning unit for 6 hours, you know, then you need a, you know, off-grid, then you need a very large battery storage system. So it's worth sort of talking to installers and considering what you want to get out of your batteries and how much you want to invest. I think, you know, the one thing I will say about batteries is you love your solar system so much more if you have one, because it feels, it's sort of, a grid connect solar system feels a little bit like you're cheating, because you're relying on the grid as your free battery. Whereas when you have your own battery storage, you know, you've turned your intermittent solar system, which produces power sometimes but not all the time, into more of a baseload solution, because regardless of when the power was generated, you could use it out of the battery at any time. So it does give you a proper sense of independence, you know, and so I hope if you're in a position, you know, batteries are expensive, they add a lot to the cost of a system. So if, you know, if you are in a position where, you know, you can afford to go battery, it really is something you'll enjoy, you'll like owning. Keep an eye on this calculator over time. We will be upgrading it. We'll probably be adding a sizing option there for where you simply want to effectively charge your battery with off-grid power and move to a time of use rate structure simply to save money. So there's some economics there, but as I say, that really depends on your utility. And so you really need to talk to a local installer that knows what different tariff rate options your local utility has and whether there's real savings there. So at the bottom of this calculator, if you want to, you can go through and basically register and put in your address and, you know, request quotes from local solar companies. And one of the great things about Solar Reviews is we really do have, you know, some of the best solar companies you know, around the country that will give you quotes. And so it really pays, before you talk to somebody about it, to understand what your goals are. You just need to be aware of the constraints that batteries have, in that you have to have a means of charging it, and if there's time of use, peak and off-peak billing, electric billing in your area, then maybe that's not such an issue. But if there's not, if it's just flat rate structure billing, then you really need to be able to generate enough solar power to charge that battery. Otherwise, you could go for a much smaller battery. There are some smaller batteries out now. I know Enphase have an option which is only a 3 kilowatt battery. And you know, there are some that are smaller than the Powerwall. There are some that are about nine or 10 kilowatts. So they're a little bit cheaper than the Powerwall. So for some people, they may be a better option. And then also there's the constraint of what will actually fit on your roof. You know, you only have so much roof space, and so if you have a flat rate structures, you don't have time of use billing where you live, then you've really got to look at, well, how much solar power can I fit on my roof? Because that's really going to limit the amount of excess power that you can get into a battery on an average day. As I said, it really is a topic that pays talking to a good installer. And when I say a good installer, I think this is really when I would particularly be going to smaller local installers rather than the big factory type solar, you know, corporations that have, you know, hundreds of salesmen that have typically come and go and, you know, haven't had a lot of training in the subtleties of some of this stuff. I think you'll find your little family-owned solar companies are going to be a lot more concerned about making sure that you really understand the pros and cons of what you're buying. You know, in terms of, you know, when you're buying a battery, solar and a battery, you're not buying a free ticket to use as much power as you like, whenever you like, when the grid's down. You'll have some power for some period of time when the grid's down, but it really is limited to, you know, the both in the total storage capacity and also in the instantaneous loads that these batteries can serve in an off-grid backup mode. Most of the batteries can only sort of serve between 5 and 7 kilowatts at a time of loads. You can't, in a backup situation, maybe have your central air conditioner and your stove on, things like that. And that's why a clever designer and battery designer, they'll explain that to you and they'll say, well, look, out of all your loads, these are the ones that would fit on it for this amount of time. And then you usually have, most of them usually have some sort of backup gateway where you wire certain circuits to be backed up, but not all the circuits in a home. Fine for you to say, well, I want my central AC backed up in a power outage. You know, like, I don't want to go through a 100 degree summer day when the grid's out, you know, and swelter, and I don't mind if that costs me some money. But most people are probably going to say, well, I'm happy to accept the limitation. I can't run my central AC because it means I can get away with $20,000 less of battery storage. So, and they really are sort of the numbers. It's pretty substantial. So that's all for now. If you've enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. It does sort of help with the motivation to make more content. And the link is in the description below to the solar calculator that we're just on. And as I say, it's usable without any sort of registration or paywall. You really only need to register if you then want to get quotes from local suppliers, which we encourage you to do. That's all for now. Goodbye.
If you enjoyed that, be sure to subscribe and watch some of our other videos.